As we head into the final five or six episodes of this great series, at least the first season of it, man, I tell you, the tension is just building with this female titan.
Irvin Smith, 57th Expedition Beyond the Walls, Part 4. Well, hello, my brothers and sisters and female titan lovers of the Nerd Nation. I, as always, am Jim, and I'm here to bring you another review on the awesome and gruesome and just cannibalistic-like tale that is Attack on Titan.
Our last episode, of course, saw us with, you know, the main point being is that they caught that bitch. They wound up catching, through a wonderful plan that Captain Irvin had put together and enacted, been able to shoot hundreds or thousands of, like, these grappling hooks into her and actually being able to trap her. So that's where the episode left off. And this episode actually picks up right there. And again, I was thinking that this was a different episode. I was thinking that this was episode 21 or 22, and it's actually, in fact, episode 20. And although a very good episode, this was, we trapped her, now let's see what we can do to go and pull the actual person out of her, because Irvin obviously thinks that, or knows, or feels in his heart, that this must be like a similar to Eren type of Titan, where it's actually a human that's inside. So we also wind up seeing, because Eren and his group, Levi's group, I guess you would say, of the scouts, they wind up going and riding on. They're still supposed to just keep pressing on, right? They're not supposed to stop and look and gawk at the Titan or anything like that. And then we wind up getting, during the course of the episode, several times it takes us to the rest of the, obviously the rest of the troops that are standing there, kind of keeping the Titans distracted and at bay at the outside of the, in the onset of the forest. The thing for me, that one of the bullet points, I guess you would call it, of this particular episode was the fact that Irvin and Levi were two of the only people that actually knew what was going on. And we wind up finding out through just kind of a series of just sort of deductions by Eren and that group, as well as, Jean and Armin and some of the other ones that are kind of on the outskirts of the forest, that after the breach about five years ago at Shiganshina, where the Colossal Titan had obviously busted through the outer wall, and then the Armored Titan appeared and busted through the inner wall, which was obviously the fall of Walmaria, and wound up leading to, ultimately, you know, about one-fifth of the world's population being wiped out. It was events after that wiped them out, but regardless, that's what was the cause, it was the catalyst, right? So Irvin didn't trust anybody that joined up with them after that point. So the only people that were in the know on the plan were people that he felt he could trust, that were 100% without a shadow of a doubt, the mole, right? The person that had gotten in there, because he believed that the female Titan had obviously, and as well as two of that, Sonny and Bean, those two Titans they had captured that were killed by someone, he believed that it's somebody that had infiltrated their ranks and had come into and joined up with, the Scout Regiment or the Walga. So, basically, a mole, if you will, is what it was. So, that for me, I thought was pretty cool and pretty profound, because at first, Eren's trying to turn everybody else in Levi's group against him, going like, yeah, doesn't that bother you that he didn't trust you enough to tell you? And eventually, Petra and, they all start talking amongst themselves and eventually come to the conclusion that he must have only kept people in the know that he was 100% sure about. And this way, he could narrow down his list of suspects much easier, right? Because he knew, he felt like it was somebody that was obviously amongst them, amidst their ranks. So, very, very cool stuff. And then we wind up seeing, as Irvin and Levi go to, like, drop down from this overhanging tree, because the female Titan is being held there in place, right? And can't move, or isn't moving, isn't struggling. Hundreds and thousands of these grappling hooks shot into her. And as they go and drop down to try to strike her neck, her weak spot, and to cut the actual human out, all of a sudden her hands that are over her neck, right, that she put over her neck instinctively, they harden up, and they almost look like, in the anime, it almost looks like ice, but they basically harden up to where they snap and they break the blades. So Irvin and Levi realize they're not going to get through that way. And for the majority of the episode, Levi's just standing on her head talking shit to her. And I actually thought it was pretty funny, because he's just like, yeah, you big bitch, you think this. And he's, going on and on. And you just kind of see this sort of dead look in the Titan's eye. Eventually, the Titan winds up going, the female Titan winds up going, and just this blood-curdling, like, Arr! I mean, it seriously, it just sounds like a bear being raped by, like, a fucking dinosaur, right? And not that I know what that sounds like, but I can imagine, right? And it's just this blood-curdling scream. Eventually, it's referred to by one of the other scouts that's on the outskirts. Is that I think it was Sasha that was saying that, you know, listen, I know sounds like that. I grew up in the farmlands and everything else. That's the sound of an animal dying. That's the sound of an animal's last, his last stand, his last, that's all he's got left, right? What this does is it's almost like a call to all the other Titans. And we see, too, that the Titans can learn. There's a couple of them that are actually trying to climb trees to get up to the people that are, you know, that are keeping them at bay at the edge of the forest. But nonetheless, Titans start rushing in from all different directions. And Irvin and his group aren't prepared for that. They do wind up taking out several of them in a wave, but these Titans aren't coming in to save the female Titan and to attack the scouts that are there, as you would think. These Titans are coming in and were called to come in, and they're cannibalizing and eating one of their own. They're eating the female Titan's body. Now, during the course of this getting of the female Titan getting eaten up by these things, by dozens of these things coming in, as well as all the scouts that are dropping and slashing them in their spots, you know that these things burn super hot and steam comes out of them. So basically what happened is that she not only had them come and eat the body of hers, but wound up actually being able to, under cover of all this smoke and mist and shit and Titan shit, she was able to actually go and the human portion of this female Titan was actually able to go and able to escape, right? Now, the neat thing about that is that Irvin goes and tells Levi to hold up before he rejoins his group, right? And, excuse me, later on, he's asked by another subordinate, why would you do that? He didn't have to go and refuel and re-this. And Levi trusts Irvin implicitly. So I think that's another thing that's worth noting as well, another bullet point, if you will. He even says, even though he probably doesn't agree with some of the shit, he says, I trust you and everything that you say, right? So Irvin, though, he knows. He knows what's going on. And he knows that after this all happened, right, even though he didn't expect it to happen this way, that the traitor is still amongst them, right? And we should assume that traitor probably has gotten a hold of some ODM gear, some maneuver gear, right? And probably a uniform or whatever of theirs, right? So the whole episode is based on that premise. And then at the end of the episode, as we see Aaron and the rest of the scouts, Gunter and Petra and Oro, as they're all going through and just kind of swinging through in their Spider-Man, with their Spider-Man-like gear through the forest of tall trees, all of a sudden we see a flare go up, and they think, well, that must be Captain Levi, so they shoot a flare up to let, you know, signal and let him know where it is. The whole time we see, and it's the last minute or two, we see it's this cloaked figure, right? And immediately I'm watching it, and it was great because my oldest son, as well as my wife, were like, oh boy, you know? And they don't show this person's face, but you just know by the music and the tone and everything that something's about to go down. Well, this person that they think is Captain Levi they're reuniting with is actually the traitor, we assume the female Titan, and winds up actually in one fell swoop coming in and actually cutting down Gunther, actually goes and takes him out and kills him, slashes his throat or what have you. Aaron goes back thinking he got hung up on something going to help him and sees his dead, lifeless body hanging there, and that's how the episode ends off, right? So absolutely wonderful. Again, can't say enough good things about this particular English dub. I think that they chose that they're spot on with probably about 99% of the characters. There's only a couple of them that sound a little bit off or a little bit out of place. But even the way that everything has been done and the way that they've reworked a little bit some of the scenes, which they sometimes have to do with dubs, because the lips don't match what needs to be said, they'll go and they'll actually take and extend a camera shot away from, or they'll cut it and clip it so you can't see the person's mouth. I think it's all been done very well, and actually I'm just very, very excited and happy that not only can I see this now in English, but then too to be able to share it with my family as well, because we're enjoying the heck out of it over here, and only 5 or 6 episodes left to go before the climax and the ending. So my episode question for you, though, because that's how things wrap up, brothers and sisters, is ultimately, when you were watching this, if you've seen it already and you know who, don't spoil it for anybody else. Don't be that guy that pisses in the punch bowl, or girl, whatever. I'm not going to be sexist here. But who do you think, or at this point, who did you think the female Titan was? Did you have a short list? Did you have... Because honestly, when I was watching this, as I went through and was watching, it seemed like a couple episodes a day and recording and uploading reviews to get up to this point. I think I caught up when it was at like episode 23 or 24. I really didn't... It happened so quick that I didn't really have time to think about it. But now I can see how, obviously, you can formulate all these different thoughts and theories and ideas when you're watching something week in and week out, and there's that 7-day break that you have to wait until you see the next episode, and all you have is time to sit around and talk and ponder and wonder. Because my son, my oldest son, I believe he's spot on with some of his guesses. My wife hasn't really made any guesses as of yet, but she's not a person who pays a whole ton of attention to a character or a character's name unless they've been featured in several episodes too. So there's a lot of characters that she's still kind of getting a grasp on. This is this person, this is this person. But I'd like to know what your thoughts are on who you think the female Titan is. Leave your comments to that question or answer that question in the comments down below. Sorry. Feel free to hit the thumbs up, the like button if you should think that I deserve it. And subscribe if you haven't done so already. We will look forward to catching all of you in the next one, Titans. Follow me on Twitter and Facebook and check out my other channels. And as always, thanks for watching.